Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, we'll talk about freefall as it'll show up on your MCAT in a kinematics question. Freefall, as the name implies, is when something just falls under its own acceleration, meaning you don't have an outside force that causes it to accelerate in any direction other than straight down. When dealing with freefall, we use the standard kinematic equations, but realize anytime x shows up, you want to use y, and anytime acceleration shows up, you want to use the acceleration of gravity, or simply g for gravity. Gravity is 9.8 meters per second squared, but on the MCAT you can simplify and we'll use 10 meters per second squared, with a negative to imply that the direction is downward. The three equations to consider for free fall have acceleration in them. The first is v final is equal to v initial plus at. We want to swap out the a for g, and since gravity is down, we change plus gt to minus, because negative implies a negative or downward direction. The second one has v final squared equals v initial squared plus 2a delta x. We want to swap the x for y, a for g, and then put a negative for the direction of gravity. And finally, the last one, delta x is equal to v initial t plus 1 over 2 at squared. We switch the x to a y, we put negative and swap the a for a g. Freefall questions will show up in one of two ways. You can have something falling downward, and then your velocity and your acceleration of gravity are both in the same direction. Or you can have something being thrown upward. The initial velocity for something thrown up is positive, but the gravity, which is slowing it down in the downward direction, is going to be negative. And one thing to keep in mind, because velocity and gravity are working against each other, v final, which is going to be v at the top, is equal to zero. So picture this. You throw something up with an initial velocity, and then as it's going higher and higher, gravity is starting to push it down and down. So the speed at which the object is going upward is going to slow down, until it comes to a complete stop, and then it'll change direction and the velocity will be downward in addition to the gravity. So it'll go from no speed at the top, going faster, 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 until it hits the ground. We'll look at this in more detail when we talk about projectile motion, but now let's try a simple freefall problem. In this problem, we're told that a rock is thrown upward and reaches a height of 6 meters. How long does it take for the rock to reach its maximum height? The first thing we want to do is identify what we're given and what we're asked for. In this case, it appears that we're only given one unit, but if you read the question carefully, we're given two. We're told that the rock reaches a height of 6 meters. That means delta y is equal to positive 6 meters. We're asked for how long it takes to reach the maximum height, and that means time is our unknown. But to solve an equation in kinematics, you need to have two givens and one unknown. The hidden given in this case is the acceleration, which is equal to gravity of negative 10 meters per second squared. Ideally, we want to use the kinematic equation that has delta y, t, and g. But the equation that meets this criteria is x is equal to v initial t plus 1 over 2 at squared. We swap the x for a y, turn the a into a g, and put a negative sign to imply the direction of gravity. When a rock is thrown upward, it has an initial velocity. The problem here is that the initial velocity is not zero, and we cannot cancel out this term. If we're solving for time, we have time showing up as t and as t squared, and if we set this up correctly, we wind up with a quadratic equation. This is not your physics class, this is the MCAT. You don't have a calculator and you cannot solve a quadratic. If you see yourself trying to do a quadratic, find another way to do it because it's going to take too long. What we want to do here is see if we can solve for another unit within a different kinematic equation so that even though we have to take an extra step, it's still easy and doable on the MCAT. So here's what we know. Looking at the kinematic equations, we know that we can't use this one because we have the quadratic. So we want to solve for time using a different equation. The other equation that relates gravity and time is v final equals v initial minus gt. This has the time unit in it, but we're also asked for a v final and v initial, which we don't have. So the other way to do this is to take our third equation, which is time independent, use that to solve for our unknown variable of velocity, and then go back to this equation and solve for time. Starting with the equation v final squared equals v initial squared minus 2g delta y, we know that v final, or the velocity at the top, is going to be zero because when you throw the rock up, it'll slow down, and come to a stop. We drop that out of the equation. We want to solve for v initial, so we'll move that over to the other side. And this gives us a new equation as follows. Negative v initial squared is equal to negative 2g delta y. We have negative on both sides, so we can cancel it out, and that means v initial squared equals 2g delta y. And then all we have to do is plug in and solve. We have 2 times g, which is 10 meters per second squared, and delta y, which is 6. I like to multiply the numbers that don't have a 10 in it first, because multiplying by 10 is the easier step. 2 times 6 is 12. 12 times 10, we just add the 0, that's 120. And if v initial squared is equal to 120, we take the square root of both sides to get v initial. 120 is very close to 121, and the square root of 121 is 11, so let's say that this is equal to 11. If you're not confident with your square root values, grab my math cheat sheet that has a lot of different equations for you to memorize for the MCAT, and you can find this on my website at leahforsci.com/MCATmath. So now that we know that 11 meters per second upward, so it's positive, is equal to our v initial, we can now use this value to plug into the next equation. The next equation we said we'll use is v final is equal to v initial plus at or minus gt. We want to solve for time, but first let's get rid of what we don't need and then isolate t. V final is 0 at the top, so we get rid of it. To isolate t, we first subtract v initial. That gives us negative v initial is equal to negative gt. Time cannot be a negative unit, and we prove that here by canceling out the negatives on both sides. Now we'll divide by gravity to isolate t, and that gives us v initial over g is equal to t. Our v initial is 11 meters per second. Gravity is 10 meters per second squared. Realize we're not using the negative because we've already accounted for that in the initial setup of the equation. We're left with just positive numbers. Now we have 11 over 10. We'll use the factor of 10 trick. When dividing by 10, it has 1 zero, so we move the decimal back one space, and time is equal to 1.1 second. How do we get second? Meters cancel out. Second cancels one of the seconds in seconds squared, and that leaves us with 1 over 1 over second. So the inverse of 1 over second is second, and that's our answer. Now I realize this was a little bit of a long-winded way to solve for the problem, so to check yourself, you can plug in the numbers and see if that makes any sense. Let's plug in what we have for here and see if we get an answer for y. We said that v initial was 11 and time was 1.1 second. We're obviously going to round all this to do it quickly. And then we're subtracting 1 over 2. Gravity is 10 and 1 second squared is just 1 squared or 1. A half times 10 times 1 is 5. So we have 11 minus 5, which is equal to 6. And lo and behold, our height was 6 meters. Be sure to join me in the next video where I take you through projectile motion and the way you want to approach it on the MCAT. You can find my entire series on translational motion by visiting my website leahforsci.com/MCATphysics. Are you stuck on a specific MCAT topic? I offer private online tutoring where I focus on your needs to strengthen your individual weaknesses. Tutoring details can be found using the link below or by visiting my website, leahforsci.com/MCATtutor. Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, The MCAT Exam Strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at MCATExamStrategy.com. By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, MCATExamStrategy.com.